one of my favorite parts about my job is that I meet a bunch of people in one day and sort of have all these different presentations and interviews. And I just came out of one interview with a startup founder, and I'm preparing for my next one. And this one I'm particularly excited about because he's really inspired a lot of thought leadership in the field of kind of office... Sorry, just one second. It's important. Hi, boss. Yeah? Oh, the location changed. Aruna Asif Ali Marg. Yeah, I can do that. Okay, see you there. Driver, stop the car. How cool is this? I mean, when you take a lot of work with you, and especially when you get stuck in Delhi traffic, then a mobile office like this one is really a dream come true. But even if you're a startup founder or an entrepreneur, or even running a small to medium-sized business, one of the hardest things is finding decent office space, especially at a reasonable rate. But this person behind me is helping create a startup for the startups.
Meet Amit Ramani, founder and CEO of Office Space Solutions. And the man behind increasing employee efficiency through his unique office. Well, not just his own employees, but actually for a lot of other startups. Amit comes from a strong background of planning and real estate and wears his vision on his sleeve to help startups or SMEs with the most daunting task, finding a decent workspace at a reasonable rate. But a startup helping startups, how do they do it?
So office is basically the ability to book office on the go, right? So just in time basis, you can book from 1 hour to 11 months a meeting room or an office or a desk. Essentially through a technology platform. So just as your business is not conventional, why should your office be?
Founded in April 2015, Amit's concept has been redefining the way work gets done in the current business environment. All of this through his just-in-time space utilization, which basically means that Office, tailor-made mobile app, enables users to find and book workspaces in their managed centers on the go and on real-time basis. A startup can book private cabins, flexi seats, as well as conference rooms. The sheer number of startups in the country has produced huge demand of office working spaces in cities. And considering the needs of startups building network, affordable rent, and great infrastructure, it becomes a win-win situation for both. But with co-working spaces mushrooming in all major cities, what is Office unique defining factor?
So our USP is complete flexibility to book on the move. So we provide a technology platform. We bring a lot of alliances to the table that really add value to our community members, such as food tie-ups, entertainment tie-ups, technology tie-ups, right? We also do a lot of eventing, right, which provide mentoring, provide learning opportunities at our centers. And clearly, we provide a complete transformation in terms of how people look at real estate and use of office space by providing a design solution that provides activity-based settings in our centers.
So, not just an office space with great Wi-Fi, Office also provides F&B services, insurance products and legal services, which seems to make it a one-stop shop for everything a nascent startup would need. But we have some burning questions that we want answers to. Co-working spaces are becoming central to startups. How is Office going to capitalize on this market? Are new-age co-working spaces and business centers changing the work culture in India? Does Office have a scalable business model?
What makes you sure that Office is going to grow and continue to work?
So just in a matter of 12 months, we have gotten about 82% occupancy in our centers. Some centers run at 100% occupancy, right? And some of these centers are vintages of 1 week old to about 12 months old, right? So we've gotten a really good response from the community, and our community is basically making us successful, right? And we are continuing to see a lot of traction around it from SMEs, from startups, and from even now from corporates. So we feel this is a hugely scalable model and has a lot of potential going forward.
Now, Office does compete with co-working spaces across the country, and I know they're on the rise. So can you talk about who your real competition is?
Competitors are the business centers which already existed, also the co-working guys that are coming up. So that's why we created our own category called pro-working. And with pro-working, what we are bringing is proximity working, professional working, productive working. We create our own category, and we strongly feel that the conventional office user is our biggest competition. There is global competition coming from likes of WeWork, so we certainly look forward to that. But, you know, as we see it, the conventional guy is our biggest competition.
Co-working spaces are central to the work ethos of startups. How is Office capitalizing on this market?
So clearly, in our community of about 2,000 people in a very short duration of 12 months, about 25% are startups, right? So we are clearly looking at that ecosystem and capturing it as one of our key categories of community that becomes part integral to our growth here. So clearly, with the startup ecosystem growing, our community and our office centers will grow as well.
How are co-working spaces changing work culture in India?
So co-working, you know, if you look at co-working, in 2006, there were two centers in the US. Today, there are over 10,000 centers, right? We are looking at a growth which is happening 50% year on year, right? So clearly, a category has been created and people are adapting it. Like, look at our growth here, right? In 12 months, we have over 2,200 members working out of our 13 different locations and, you know, growing very, very fast. So clearly, it's a category that's gotten created. Now, we call it pro-working because we feel that it's not just for the startup ecosystem, it's for SMEs, it's for also the corporate side. So it's a new way of working, and clearly, co-working is here to stay.
Office provides really gorgeous offices. I mean, it's the sort of thing that I would love to work in, and I think that there is that something magic that happens when people from different spheres come together and maybe you spark ideas that you never would have expected. But the fact of the matter is that WeWork is coming to India, and WeWork is a giant in the US. It's really leading the co-working space revolution, kind of started it. And so I wonder what will happen when that encroaches on this territory. Will Office be able to survive? We'll have to see. Anyway, that's what I think. Let's hear what the mentors have to say.
Our first mentor is Neeta Kapoor, head at India New Ventures, NewsCorp. Neeta is leading VC Edge, a research platform that provides data to professionals that are a part of the investment ecosystem. Neeta has over two decades of experience in communications, marketing, and brand building. Meet Ashish Taneja, co-founder and managing director of GrowX Ventures, an early stage investment firm. Ashish works with a plethora of startups very closely and has a keen eye to spot the one in a million, or in our case, in a billion.
The idea of Office is great. It's not original. It's been done before. In fact, a lot of accelerators and incubator programs are already offering that. One advice for Office is get more offices under management as fast as you can. Collaborate and offer value-added services now.
The co-working opportunity is really taking up shape. There are some 10-12 companies or startups who are already in this space and have significant capability. I don't see any differentiation, right? So, you know, between an office and the bunch of others. Basic parameters or requirements which an entrepreneur is looking for when they're doing at their office, there are not a lot of options available generally when it comes to real estate. What's available is expensive. So I think that's the biggest challenge, you know, finding properties at the right price point which they can, you know, sublease to smaller tenants. Yeah.
If there's one state that aims to lead the startup revolution in India, it's Telangana. And T-Hub, a startup ecosystem based in Telangana, is promoting various startups and aims to be at the forefront of this golden era for entrepreneurship. Recently, the state announced that it was launching an initiative to connect startups in India to global market opportunities and invite global new age companies to invest back in India. So today on State of the Startup, we want to know, what should we expect from this initiative? And what does it mean for India's startup ecosystem?
Telangana has been in the news recently for all its efforts in pushing for startups. While Hyderabad has good infrastructure and a growing technology talent pool, many startups get caught in red tapeism and don't hit the ground for very long. Startup ecosystem builder T-Hub identified this and has now launched T-Bridge after partnering with Thai Silicon Valley and Uber, a new program that will connect Indian startups with global market opportunities.
Think of two organizations coming together to breed startups which are made in India, but going global. I think this could be a perfect bridge for startups going from India globally, and also for a lot of global innovation to start to percolate here and leverage the domestic Indian market.
I think they are the only state in the country today which has a very specific program to encourage startups and encourage the ecosystem around it. So the government of India is trying to really do, work hard to build the ecosystem. There's been multiple slew of initiatives and regulatory approval processes that has happened in the last 5-6 quarters since the new government has come into play.
T-Bridge will also enable startup communities in India and around the world to exchange and share ideas and innovate. In addition, the program aims to create a good network of mentors, VCs and incubators in the Indian startup ecosystem.
Well, I think this kind of tie-up means that the Indian startup ecosystem is kind of arriving on the global scene. India is emerging as really the new startup ecosystem which can expand on scale. We are now, I think, the third largest hub, and global investors are looking for opportunities.